when it hits the climax, you can't wait to continue. That can only be said about this Open Herd book 3, because after chapter 9, it's only increasing our wishes to read the chapter 10 ASAP, and if not the whole book. Chapter 9 build-up, named as Ethan's moral stand has come with unexpected consequences. We know what's happening. In the last chapters, we saw we had a patient, and that patient had no chance of living with the normal medicines and normal treatments out there. So Ethan put him for the drugs, and it was sort of illegally, so to speak. And Harper comes to know about it, and Harper reports to the board, thinking that it was us, but it was Ethan. So to save our main character, because Harper was blaming us, Ethan hands himself to the board, and he has been suspended for this time period until any further notice, and until the case, or sort of the legal case that Ethan's gonna face in the hospital. So we see the team is again working without a leader, but Bloom steps in and says that this team has a leader, and that's now Tobias. So Tobias is getting the leadership when Ethan is absent. Now we can congratulate him, Tobias, because I sort of felt like at the moment, and Tobias tries to put up on an act, sort of trying to find a file and sort of ruffle through its pages, trying to find a case, and I appreciate that, because Ethan did what he did, and Tobias is now, because he doesn't have anything to do with this, so we might also just increase his morals. So you have option what to do. I congratulate him, and then we get a case, and again we vote on the case, we go there, and the case is in the symptoms, so to speak, of that lady. The symptoms were really unnatural, and we were trying to find a solution to that, and we get this diamond scene. We can go to that patient's house to sort of find more about the disease and some backstory about the patient. That always helps. Now this is diamond scene. We can go with Tobias. If you play this, it's gonna be super awesome, because you're gonna learn a lot about and this was really awesome, because we get a lead on the patient, and also we come to know about the rivalry between Tobias and Ethan. We learn about Ethan's side of story, but also we get to know about Tobias' side of story in this premium scene, and it was quite worth it, because Tobias, we learn how Tobias regrets things he did back then, and how Naveen saw Ethan's true potential, and sort of there was a good competition, and competition always improves you, but how Tobias sort of went beyond the competition and tried to jeopardize Ethan, and now he really wants to get back with Ethan. So by the end of this book, we will see more about this, how Ethan and Tobias get back together. We have already seen it once or twice in some diamond scenes, but we'll see it more. So Tobias doesn't want to take away Ethan's spot. He wants to work with Ethan and challenge himself. He wants Ethan to challenge himself so that he can be better, the better he can get. And that's really good. And also, Tobias envies our main character too, and thinks that our main character really is someone different than anyone. We have certain traits. Then we go on about this, and more or less we solve the case a bit later in the book, but before that we do some other stuff. Mainly we Harper comes to us and talks with us and asks for our forgiveness, and then you can forgive her or you can't forgive her. It's totally up to you. It's your choice. For my case, I thought, yeah, let's forgive her, because we're gonna work together, so there's no need to, you know, there's no need in keeping the old wounds alive, because it's only gonna come to hurt you, bite you. So yeah, Harper did what she did, but now if she's regretting, she tells her side of story. So yeah, I forgive her. Let me know what you did and what you think about this Harper thing. And then we go home. I think we meet also Bryce and Jackie's intern Jade. Again, we are thinking we're getting some hints toward a big gamble in the future chapters, because Jade is interested about research and stuff, but Jackie wants to push her in, you know, having more patients and solving more cases, being a proper doctor. And Jade's face falls off, and we sort of worry, like, how this thing's going to end, how this thing's gonna what it is going to lead to. Now, we're gonna see this in the later chapters, but we'll wait for that. And then we go to our house, and there we have a conversation with Alicia, and Alicia is clearly down. And before also, we went to Ethan's house, and again, you get a diamond scene. You can have Ethan cook for you. You can have a meal there. You can learn the insider news with Ethan, how he's doing after this thing. And you will know Ethan is, well, awkwardly really calm and not affected by this at all. He thinks, wow, you see a complete different side of him, you know. He's just not bothered by anything. He's like, yeah, you know, I'm really free. I haven't felt like this in years. So I would say this is really fine for me. And then you come back, you are relieved seeing Ethan like that. And then you have this conversation with Alicia, because Alicia is totally angry. He also thinks you did it, because Ethan Ramsey, the great doctor, cannot ever do that. But then we get this diamond scene, and we play this zombie game, sort of. And then we have this conversation, and we tell Alicia how this is happening. Bloom is trying to do something that would put more people at risk. It definitely beneficial to people, and it can recover a lot of people. But also, on the other hand, it's an experiment, so to speak. So it's going to benefit. If it benefits a lot of people, and on the contrary, it's going to harm a lot of people. So we try to tell him the side of the story, and try to tell him why Ethan did it. And we also apologize. They also apologize, sort of, you know, a both side thing. And then also, one thing to mention, we played as a zombie, so now there's a zombie book coming up, but we had a character of zombie and others. So they said the game was about an apocalyptic situation. Now, I don't know if, you know, because they make games out of real situations, so in the zombie book, they're probably going to go for an apocalyptic situation too. It is going to be something similar to that. They try to tease something. We don't know. We'll never know unless or until it releases. But we start everything out with Alicia. There was a line, and I really liked it. It said, you have won your friend back, irrespective of the thing, if you win the game or not. So I really liked the line. Moving on again, in the usual pace, or in the usual manner how we solve our cases, we get hints from our friends talking, or anyone else talking about something else. We get the clue from them. So Sienna and Aurora were talking about something, and then we finally realized, oh, I just solved our patient's case. It was related to copper poisoning. So we explain everything to them. Again, we get credit for our brilliant diagnosis and brilliant thinking, and then we're done. We come back to our diagnostics room. Tobias, our main character, Harper, all the characters are really happy, and then we see Ethan coming in. Ethan comes into the diagnostics room, claims back his chair, and we sort of worry, is it gonna spark the rivalry between Ethan and Tobias again? And then Harper worries, wow, you're going to have to get out of here pretty soon, because you can get into trouble. Ethan says, no, I'm here to stay. My suspension has been removed because I'm not suspended anymore. I'm back. I'm back in the business. So how did he come back? We worry. Of course, Bloom definitely did. Bloom doesn't like to lose. So in the aftermath of this, what Bloom is going to do, he's furious about our main character, on Ethan, about Suzette, about this. And now Ethan got off Bloom's radar, or Bloom's chains, quite easily, to be honest, without any trouble. So he's pissed off, he's super mad, he's angry, and he is crazy about this Bloom, definitely, because Bloom never likes to lose, and Bloom never gets happy whenever he doesn't get what he wants. So Bloom always ends up getting what he wants, and if he doesn't, then it pisses Bloom off. So we're gonna have to see how this plays out in the next chapters. Let me know, guys, in the comment section below how you feel about this, and yeah, see you in the next video. Bye.